Hey everyone, Ivan here, and welcome to the first part of the YOLOv5 series. In this series, we'll learn how to train a YOLOv5 model in a custom dataset, from start to finish. We'll look at how to install YOLOv5 and its dependencies on both Google Colab and on Windows. Then we'll learn about collecting and labeling our custom data. We'll also learn how to properly configure and monitor training with the Weights and Biases machine learning tools. This video, part 1, focuses on two things in particular: quickly setting up YOLOv5 on Google Colab, and diving deep into what it takes to install it on Windows successfully with GPU support. In both cases, the end goal is the ability to run inference. In other words, having the pre-trained model detect objects in our images or videos. If you have any comments or questions at any point throughout this video, feel free to leave them in the comment section down below, and let's get started. I've actually already made an overview video about training YOLOv5 with Weights and Biases integration in an example Colab notebook. If you want to get the feel for how the training will look like, I really recommend that you check that video out. You could call that part 0 of the series. In the Colab notebook from that video, the first cell sets things up. The second cell runs inference, aka detecting objects in an example image. The command detect.py automatically downloads a YOLOv5 model to perform inference on a selected image. We can select a new example image and see how the model will do on it. We'll come back to Colab when we talk about training in part 3, but that's really pretty much it for now. Colab is great, but when it comes to inference, there's a very serious drawback. We can't run detection in real time, save from our webcam feed. That's where we need to get our hands dirty and set things up on a system like Windows. The first thing we need to do is to download and unzip the YOLOv5 repository from GitHub. Now let's go over the requirements outlined in the repo. We need to be running Python 3.8 or later, which means that even though I have the good old Python 3.6 installed, I'll need to go ahead and get myself a newer version. We'll also need to have these modules installed. Since I have another version of Python already installed, I will leave the add Python 3.9 to path box unchecked and then do it manually afterwards. We can see that the 3.9 version has now appeared in the Python folder. However, if I open the console, it still uses Python 3.6 by default. Since we'll be running YOLOv5 through the console, it is crucial that we call the right version of Python. If your console already calls the right Python version, feel free to skip the next step. Environmental path variables allow us to call certain programs from the console anywhere in our system, like say running Python 3.9 inside the YOLOv5 repository folder. In this PC, I will click on Properties and then go into the Advanced System Settings to see the environmental variables. I'll click on the Path variable and change Python 3.6 to Python 3.9. Now we can check and make sure that we're indeed using Python 3.9. YOLOv5 uses PyTorch, currently one of the most popular machine learning frameworks to define models, run inference, and perform training. ML frameworks typically provide an easy and efficient way to run essential inference and training calculations on a GPU, which tends to be orders of magnitude faster than running similar calculations on a CPU. Well, that's provided that you go through the pain of installing everything correctly, but no worries, that's what I'm here for. Let's install PyTorch as a Python module. We'll go to the official Get Started page and select the Windows build that we want. If you're on an Intel-based Mac and have an NVIDIA GPU, you can select Mac as your OS and proceed with enabling GPU support. Regardless of the OS, if you don't have an NVIDIA GPU, you can select the CPU build and proceed with the video. Alright, if you're using the GPU option, we also need to install the correct version of NVIDIA's parallel computing platform, CUDA, which is used to enable GPU acceleration for training and inference. I'll go with CUDA 11. We can go to CUDA 11 download page, select our operating system, which is Windows 10 in my case, and download the installer file. When it's downloaded, we can launch the file and begin installation. Upon completion, we'll be asked to restart the computer. Now that we have installed CUDA, we can install GPU-compatible PyTorch as well. First, we will copy this pip install command. Next, we'll run the console inside the Python scripts folder, paste the command from the PyTorch website there, and press enter. After successfully installing PyTorch and CUDA, there are a few other Python modules that YOLOv5 needs. There is a list of these modules in the requirements.txt file, and we can run pip install our requirements.txt inside the YOLOv5 folder to install them. And just as everything was going well, we got a very scary looking error. There's a problem installing PyCOCOTools. It's really easy to miss behind all of the redness of this exception, but there's actually a little sentence asking us to install Microsoft C++ build tools with a link. So I followed the instructions and installed the build tools, which required another system restart. I also used a different pip install command from the PyCOCOTools GitHub page, where they say they made minor changes to get it to work on Windows. I ran the pip install requirements.txt command again, just to double check, and this time it does say that we have all the necessary modules installed. Now, to run inference, we can open the console inside of the YOLOv5 folder and run python detect.py source 1 command. The integer is the index of the webcam to use. Since I have two webcams, I call source 1 to start inference using my second webcam. We can now see it working! YOLOv5 uses OpenCV in the background to display video, and we can click Q inside the OpenCV window to stop the program. We can also run inference in an image or in a video by passing a path to it instead of the webcam index. Let's try it with this image. We can even pass a link to a YouTube video here. However, please note that the first time I tried that, it didn't actually work, as it was saying that some modules still weren't installed. I then went ahead and also pip installed PyPhy and YouTube DL modules, and then everything worked fine. One important thing to note here is that when we start inference, by default it downloads the smallest YOLOv5 model. Add the weights parameter to specify which model to use. Small, medium, large, or extra large models. For example, this is the large model, we pass weights, YOLOv5, YOLOv5.pt, and the weights will be downloaded automatically. The smaller models tend to be a little less accurate, but are faster. While the larger ones tend to require more computing power to run, they usually do better with accuracy. It's definitely a trade-off. It depends on what hardware you have available for training and where the model will be deployed, on a phone, on a laptop, on a self-driving car, and so on. Now we know how to run inference. YOLOv5 is an implementation of a YOLO-type network in Python with PyTorch. This means that we can open any of the Python files, including the tech.py that we were just running, and be able to modify them and fairly easily add them to our own Python projects. In comparison, the original YOLO networks were programmed in C and used the Darknet Deep Learning framework. It definitely had its advantages in speed and, well, the fact that we wouldn't have YOLO networks without it, but it did make it rather difficult to integrate with Python code. That's it for this video. Stay tuned for the next one where we'll cover data collection and labeling. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the comment section down below and I'll be happy to answer them. And consider subscribing to our channel to see the upcoming parts of the series. And thank you for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it and found it useful.